Across our planet, on every continent, there is a volcano. Although most are in a dormant state, we still see on average 50 to 70 eruptions every year, some of which are extremely destructive, destroying people's lives and property. But the Earth is not the only place in the solar system where these dramatic events unfold, because other planets and moons have their own volcanic stories to tell. Evidence of past volcanic activity has been found on all of the rocky inner planets and many of the solar system's moons. Our moon, for example, has vast areas covered with ancient lava flows, while Mars boasts Olympus Mons, the largest volcano ever discovered. However, most of these volcanic features formed millions of years ago and are now just the scars of once active worlds. But we do know of at least five bodies throughout the solar system, including Earth, that are still volcanically active. The word volcano comes from the Roman god of fire, Volcanus, and nowhere is that name more suited than Io. With hundreds of active volcanoes, this rocky moon of Jupiter is considered the most volcanic world in the solar system. The hellish moon is covered with volcanoes, spewing fountains of lava and sulfurous gases high above its bizarre surface. Here, you will not find lakes of water, but instead great lakes of molten rock. The largest, named Loci Patera, is more than 126 miles across, which is more than 202 kilometers across. It is a million times the area of any lava lake found on Earth. It is a vision of hell. This photo, captured by Voyager 1 in 1979, reveals the bizarre volcanic lake from above as a giant shield-shaped black feature with a mysterious island in the middle. Research has shown that cooling molten rock in the volcanic lake periodically sinks, allowing a dramatic wave of fresh lava that starts at one end to flow around the middle island and converge on the other side. A phenomenon that strangely occurs once every 500 days or so. In 2007, NASA's New Horizons spacecraft captured an eruption in action, which can be seen in this sequence of photos. The incredible time-lapse is over an 8-minute period and shows a plume of volcanic debris around 200 miles high, which is around 320 kilometers high, drifting above the moon's hellish surface. Io is being stretched and squeezed in a gravitational tug of war between Jupiter and the other large Galilean moons. Its rocky surface bulges up and down during the process, similar to how our moon affects the oceans of Earth. But on Io, tidal forces generate tremendous amounts of heat in the moon's interior, causing subsurface magma oceans that are seeking any available escape to relieve the immense pressure from within. You can imagine it a bit like squeezing a ball of clay in your hand. Eventually, the clay becomes warm due to friction, and this is similar to what is happening on Io, just on a much larger and more violent scale. Closer to home, and we find Venus, a planet with more volcanoes than any other planet in the solar system. There is no doubt volcanic activity has played a pivotal role in its history, but it is unsure whether they are still active. Venus is a difficult planet to study because of its thick, corrosive, scorching atmosphere, meaning that spacecraft can only survive for a matter of minutes on its surface, unlike Mars, where they can last for years. A recent study has possibly identified 37 volcanic structures that may indicate that Venus is still active, however, although scientists are yet to image them directly. Most of the volcanoes on Venus are classed as shield volcanoes, such as the planet's largest, Maat Mons. But there are some unusual volcanic features that have been discovered using radar images captured by the Magellan spacecraft in the early 1990s. These strange pancake-like domes can be found across the planet, and likely formed when unusually thick lava oozed out of the surface and spread evenly in all directions. This strange dome-shaped volcano has lava channels radiating from the center and is about 62 miles across or 100 kilometers across. Several magnificent ancient flows can be seen that resemble the shape of a fan and once again were likely formed by very thick, viscous lava. Other than Earth, Io, and possibly Venus, no other world in the solar system is known to have actively erupting volcanoes spewing out magma. There are, however, frozen worlds in the outer solar system where flowing ice takes the place of molten rock. The very idea of a frozen volcano, known as a cryovolcano, is so strange that it was never even considered a possibility until the Voyager missions in 1979. While flying past the moons of the gas giants, the twin spacecraft sent back bizarre images that resembled smooth lava plains and volcanic-like mountains. Most people define the word volcano as an opening in the Earth's surface from which molten rock, gases, and volcanic ash can escape. A cryovolcano isn't all that different. It forms from pressure beneath the surface, but rather than molten rock, it erupts molten ice, sometimes called cryomagma. They can erupt violently or flow gently, just like the volcanoes we see here on Earth. And in 2005, the Cassini spacecraft captured plumes of ice being ejected from Saturn's bright white moon, Enceladus. Although not in the form of a towering volcanic mountain, the south pole of Enceladus is scattered with more than 100 geyser-like features. The presence of these powerful jets indicate that liquid water was bubbling up from a layer under the moon's frozen crust, providing evidence of a subsurface ocean. It is thought that oceans of water a short distance beneath the frigid surface is heated by tidal interactions with Saturn, similar to the process that makes Io so volcanic. When the icy material bursts out of the moon's frozen crust, some of it falls back onto the moon, replenishing its bright white surface, while the rest escapes into space and forms part of Saturn's magnificent ring. A similar cloud of icy debris has also been seen coming from Jupiter's moon Europa, indicating that it too may have a subsurface ocean. But orbiting the solar system's most distant planet, Neptune, the mysterious moon Triton, is where cryovolcanism was first observed. As Voyager 2 flew past Triton in 1989, marking the first and last time the moon was ever visited, it captured incredible images of its unusual surface. Triton is a rugged moon covered with rising blobs of ice, faults, and frozen lava flows composed of water and other ices. However, its surface is also extremely young and sparsely cratered, indicating that it is still geologically active. The dark streaks seen across Triton's south polar region are thought to be dust deposits left by recent eruptions of nitrogen ice. Scientists believe the eruptions are created by dark particles inside Triton's ice caps absorbing the distant sunlight, which slowly warms the ice and causes pressurized gas pockets to jet out and drift across its frozen surface. Volcanism outside of Earth mainly occurred in the early stages of the solar system, when the planets were much hotter. Now, only Earth and Io are confirmed to have molten rock spewing from violent chasms in their surfaces. Venus may well be added to that list in time, but further research is required. Many of the icy worlds in the outer solar system have in recent times revealed themselves to also be active, erupting molten ice instead of molten rock. Even Pluto has a possible active cryovolcano, seen by New Horizons in 2015. These distant, frozen worlds may seem like frigid wastelands at first glance, but if we take a closer look, there seems to be a mystery hidden below the surface waiting to burst free.